the funniest thing that a young person could say is, "I got a plan." Hmm. When you don't even have a clue.
All right, I know that's right.
First, the funniest thing. You want to make God laugh? You want to make God laugh? Tell God your plan.
All right.
Okay? He will laugh and say, okay. But the good thing about God is He will let you go your way.
Yeah.
Go on out there. I tell them all the time, let me know how that works out. Nothing on me. Hoping that it don't work. But age, time, history have told me that anything that ain't right ain't gonna work.
All right.
Anything that's not of God, not gonna work. It's not gonna happen. But you go on. Maybe it'll work for you. But from what I've seen and what I know, it's not gonna work. So the man, he goes out, and the Bible says that he lived righteously. I had to go to Wikipedia this morning because I wanted to be sure what prodigal meant. Prodigal means somebody who spends extravagantly, lavishly, to no end. Okay? The biggest thing you can do is give a fool $1,000. He'll be back. The first thing you can do is, so this young man, now, Reverend Reuben on last, I prayed about this. Reverend Reuben on last week talked about the straight and the narrow.
That's right.
Now, he talked about the straight, so let me talk about, he said the Broadway. On Broadway, this is where they want to end up at. On Broadway, it's supposed to be easy street. There's plenty of room for you to do what you want to do. Do your own thing, be who you want to be, go where you want to go, act any kind of way you want to act on Broadway.
All right.
That's where people, not just young people, but people, it's really bad when the seniors end up on Broadway.
All right.
The folks that you think ought to have no sense end up on Broadway, hanging out on Broadway. Okay? I told y'all a long time ago, the biggest thing that California did was, one of the worst things that California did was they legalized marijuana. Mm-hmm. Oh, it got quiet at your house, huh? They legalized it. They got more grandmas in line. Kids can't get it no more. Brady got it. Granny got to hold him down. We on Broadway. So the young man went, and the Bible says, I didn't say it. It said he spent all he had.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I've been broke. But I was always able to get a dollar. You know? I was always able to get some gas, but you know, I've been broke. I'm broke right now, as a matter of fact. But he spent all he had. Now, somebody asked the question, is it pride? Or was it ignorance? No. Because the Bible says that he went and got a job. He went and got a job. I ain't mad at nobody gonna go get a job. He took a job because he needed to eat. Wasn't the best job. And this is what happens to people when they stray away from God. You start taking anything. You start accepting anything. The Bible tells us, it tells us real clear that you are not the tail. You are the head. So why would you want to go do a tail job? Oh. Why would you want to put yourself in a situation where you got to accept anything? So he's down there with the pigs now. Against his religion, nasty. And can't nobody say it like Pastor David said. When you with the pigs, you smell like the pigs. When you with the pigs, you look like the pigs. And it got to the point where he almost started to eat like the pigs. Right. But then, this is what tells me that there is a God.
Yeah.
This is what tells me that there is salvation. The Bible says that he came to save. Now, don't you throw away nobody.
All right, amen.
Don't you give up on nobody.
Yeah.
Because one day they might come to themselves.
Yeah.
All I gotta do is just come on back.
Yeah.
One day they might wake up.
Yeah.
And you don't want to be the one that looking back. You didn't help me when I was down. That's okay. I prayed for you.
Yeah.
While you was in the hall.
Yeah.
I prayed for you while you was down on Broadway.
Yeah.
I prayed for you when you was lost and destitute. I prayed for you when you didn't know your own self. The Bible says he came to himself.
Yeah.
Come on back. Come on back. Then the Bible says that as he came to himself, he says, I'll go home.
Yeah.
I'll go home. Right. Now that's a iffy situation. Mm. Y'all had kids to move out?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And they had to come back?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What'd you say? Come on.
Come on.
You didn't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now. You didn't want it to happen, but you said, come on.
Yeah.
And then you have the nerve to try to drop some rules. You have the nerve to say, this is how it's going to be now.
Exactly.
Now, not. You let him back in. The father saw the son. I was lost,
but now
I'm found.
Yeah.
I was lost, sinking in sin.
Right.
I was far from a peaceful shore.
Yeah.
But the master of the sin,
yes,
he heard my despair.
Yes,
from the waters,
yes, sir.
He lifted me.
Right.
Now safe. And the Savior, when the Father saw his son, when the Father saw him afar off, you know what your boy looked like?
Yeah.
Down the street. You know how Joseph walked?
Yeah.
You can see him anywhere. You know how your daughters look?
Yeah.
You can see him anywhere.
Right.
When he saw his son afar off, the Bible says, that he ran,
and
you see the old man running to meet his son, put his arms around him, blessed him with a kiss. The son that was lost is now found. The son that went astray, he's now back home. Oh, we gonna have a party. We gonna praise the Lord. When they go, it's okay. But when they come back, praise the Lord. Come on back, give your life to God.
pray that the good Lord bless you in the Lord today. Be kind to others. Stay 6 feet away. Keep your mask on. Keep your gloves on. Use your sanitizer. Be safe. Pray for us, and we'll be praying for you that God will bless you real good. One announcement is that the service this morning that is usually put on YouTube will not be on YouTube until